Coming up on the Better Buildings Challenge Swap.
Welcome to our kitchen.
We're not sure if they're necessarily controlling it all as well as they could.
Oh, here we go.
All that air is just losing itself.
Seriously?
Can America's healthiest grocery store give the leading global hospitality company another outlook on saving energy? Will Hilton's team of experts help Whole Foods Market's team think differently? One Hilton Hotel, one Whole Foods Market. Hosted by Maria Vargas from the Department of Energy. Two teams swapped.
Welcome to San Francisco.
Thank you.
We're delighted you guys are here for the Better Buildings Challenge Swap.
The whole idea behind the Better Buildings Challenge Swap is to find role models for commercial and industrial partners in the marketplace and have leading organizations work together to try and find solutions and identify opportunities to saving energy.
Hilton, you're up. You're going to take a walk in their store, see what you can find. You ready?
We're ready. We're excited.
I've walked hundreds of hotels, so this is the first time that I've had the opportunity to swap and walk a store.
Let's go.
Let's do it. It's a high volume store, so we have a lot of foot traffic coming in for dinners and lunches, and it's a 24/7 operation.
Welcome to our kitchen. We're excited to see what you guys can come up with. Please have at it.
Let's do it.
A little smaller than ours, but let's take a look.
Let's go.
Kitchens in the grocery space are a significant energy consumer. For Whole Foods Market in particular, the kitchens use a lot of energy.
Hey Randy, there's a great idea, you know, the controls with your knees.
With water cost in California, this is a great way. We've been trying to find a way for our employees to kind of be more engaged with water usage. We've been putting in sometimes the elbow openers, and we've got some foot sinks, so that's a really great takeaway.
That's a great idea. We gotta take that back.
I've never seen three guys in suits standing in a kitchen, but all jokes aside, you know, I think they approach it very similar to how we would approach it.
Where are these guys heading next?
Oh, here we go.
Yes, of course they spot
the one door that's low.
This is refrigerated space behind the door, and then conditioned space outside the door, so all that air is just losing itself.
But so the local utility actually offers rebates for the seals on the gaskets for walk-ins like this, or for even reach-ins, and basically get them changed almost free of charge.
For us, refrigeration is a big thing here at Whole Foods Market. It's the heart and lungs of our building, and it also has the largest energy as well as direct emissions impact for our facilities.
All right, here we are, except here we are is up there. Who's coming up the ladder with me to see the refrigeration racks?
Seriously?
Hey.
I feel sorry for the guy that has to change a compressor up there.
It's all part of squeezing big things into small places, my friend.
All right.
You ready?
It's a nice setup up here.
Thank you very much. Before we dive in, let me show you a little bit of our control system. What's on, what's off? What's in defrost, what's having issues. So this is, all the green dots are indicating that these systems are all online, all operating as they need to be. The orange dots are indicating those cases that are in defrost.
The things that we found was that we're not sure if they're necessarily controlling it all as well as they could.
I wonder if they are continuously commissioning and how they're monitoring those controls.
Or just how they're monitoring it. I mean, just when some guy climbs up the chair and looks at the screen up here, you know, there's not a lot of people here at the store, so it's not a lot of people watching the ship, so to speak. And that's where they may be missing the boat, is that they have the equipment in there, but is it running as good as it should be?
So this must be the makeup unit for the entire store. It's really important to make sure this coils are clean, it's working properly.
They have several hoods coming in, usually with this cold climate that we have here in San Francisco. They could capture some of that heat and preheat the air coming in.
They're directly exhausting all of the air conditioning and all of the ventilation, and there's a huge opportunity for them to take that exhaust, recapture some of that,
and reheat and or cool, depending on the season, some of their makeup air units. So it's just a fantastic opportunity.
So how do you guys drive team member engagement when it comes to energy efficiency?
Team member engagement is extremely important. The fact of the matter is the folks that are in the store make sure that the store pumps on a daily basis, make sure that we're not only serving our customers and providing the best food to those customers, but that, you know, they're checking on the cases and making sure that the building is operating the way it needs to operate.
All right, gentlemen, here we are on the sales floor. Love to see what you guys can find. Everything from lighting to refrigerated cases, HVAC. The world is yours.
Nice job.
Nice job on the lighting and the LED. Obviously, these hi-hats are compact fluorescent. There's probably a little bit of an opportunity there to get some rebates.
You can do those out to LEDs. Not sure if these T8s here are third generation T8s.
Yeah, so I noticed there's a lot of daylight coming through the front of the store, yet all of the lights right by the entrance are still on.
Yeah, they're all on. Good daylighting opportunities.
Absolutely.
Yeah, let's check out some of those refrigerated cases. Really great lighting for the customer, really enhances it, LED lighting. Some of these closed cases are really helping keep in that refrigeration, but these open cases, pretty big opportunity. What do you think?
Absolutely.
If you close these, you can probably save a lot of money.
Absolutely.
And it's really cold in here still.
We did recognize the lighting in a lot of their display cases to be state of the art. It's LED. And that's kind of their showcase. That's their jewelry box to selling to the customer. And they should be very proud of that. So overall, lighting is great. And with a few tweaks and a couple of great ROIs, they can be even better.
I wasn't necessarily expecting to see so many similarities just in the way that they approach all of these things, but also in the opportunities that we saw throughout the store, I think are very similar opportunities that what we see so often at our hotels as well.
I'm feeling excited by the opportunity to take our team over to the Hilton and see what we can do to point out some good opportunities there as well.
Hilton Worldwide found numerous opportunities for Whole Foods Market to save energy. How will the Whole Foods Market team fare at the largest hotel on the West Coast?
Wow, you could fit about 5 of our stores in there.
Yeah. That's chilled water in and out, right? That doesn't make any sense.
Coming up in the next episode, Hilton Worldwide hands their keys over to the Whole Foods Market team. How much can they learn from each other and save by working together? Find out in episode 2.